Hey, look what we found.
Why are we rehearsing again?
It's for the annual Venice Beach Battle of the Bands competition. It's on Saturday and Joni's entered us for it.
It's $500 if we win.
What, has she got you all jobs?
Well, four of us. Tina, John and me are working for that new special effects company and Rachel got a job at the restaurant. Come on, Rach, it's at the Press of Peace.
The Press of Peace? Isn't that a place that like takes 6 weeks to get one table?
Eight if you want to sit near the waiter. It'll be good. You'll get to spill soup all over Antonio Banderas.
Yeah, I suppose. And at least then we'll be able to save up enough money to get the car fixed.
Yeah, that makes me think now. Maybe I shouldn't have went for that job with,
What are we doing, guys? Rehearsing or talking?
Remind me. Which is less likely to open up and swallow us whole? The ground or Tina?
Wow, that's the first time I've ever choreographed a routine where the buildings move more than the dancers.
Brad?
Yeah?
What's that job you were telling us you got right before the show?
Well, it's not so much of a job, as well as kind of more like a gig.
A gig?
Yeah, like a part-time, short-term, very temporary gig.
What kind of gig?
Short-term, Saturday job, singing their boy band type.
Dude, what?
Well, it was only until we had enough money to repair the car that I didn't realise you'd all get jobs. Anyway, it's nothing big anyway. It's just, you know, they're a new band called Guyz Incorporated and they were desperate for more people. So I thought I'd go along and...
Bradley, I can't believe that you joined a rival band.
Especially one called Guyz Incorporated.
They're not a rival band, though.
And there's nothing to say that any of the S Club can't join other bands. Well, as long as they're in this one, obviously.
Actually, there is.
I direct your attention to the S-Club constitution, which I started compiling before we left Miami, with your full agreement.
That's only because we wanted you to shut up during Buffy the Vampire Slayer.
And it states, Rule 47A, that no member of this band can sing, dance, or make rhythm with any other sing, dance, or rhythm-making act. So, Bradley, do you denounce your boy band and their evil ways?
Brad, for a quiet life, just do it.
No, because his constitution is stupid.
Paul, for a quiet life, you just forget that stupid constitution.
But it took me a whole pack of felt-tip pens. So, the rule says that you cannot play with S Club until you've renounced your new job.
In that case, I can't play with S Club.
You can't let Brad just go like that. He doesn't really want to leave.
Bradley's a big boy. When he realises the mistake he's made, he'll come back and he'll apologise.
And what if he don't?
What if he goes for good? What if we all split up and we never ever see each other again, even if we live to be 30?
Hannah had this dream. Well, a nightmare, really.
Not the one when you're in the middle of that dance routine and then you suddenly realise that you haven't got any clothes on.
No.
Oh no, that's my nightmare, isn't it?
No, it was about the band breaking up. It started off in the dream with one person leaving.
Hannah, don't worry. It's just a dream. The band isn't splitting up and nobody's leaving.
Okay, bye.
Bye! Where are you going?
Start my job at the restaurant. Wish me luck.
Can everyone just calm down, Hannah? Good. Well, I'm going to go and get myself a drink and then I'm going to go and get ready to meet Zoey.
Oh, Zoey.
And until then, just remember that your fears are completely irrational, your dream wasn't a prediction, and there is nothing going on supernatural here. Okay, silly question, but why is there a severed head fridge?
The creepy effects company are doing a big horror movie and, well, they've run out of space, so our boss asked if we could store some of the stuff here.
Well, could someone tell me about it before I find it eating my pickle sandwich?
Oh, sorry, didn't realise it'd freak you so much.
Freak me? I'm not freaked. It would take a lot more than that to freak me out.
What a man, eh?
So, I said to DiCaprio, Leo, you can go to bed if you want. Me? I came here to party. That's what I said.
Excuse me, can I take your order, please?
Hi, wine. So he goes upstairs all by himself. Wine, thanks, bye-bye.
Hi, may I take your order, please?
No, wine. You're supposed to bring us the wine list first, okay?
Am I? Oh, yeah. My God, I'm sorry.
Thanks.
Oh, my God, I'm sorry. I think you guys need a little more time.
Sorry, I'm looking for someone.
I know. Do you think you recognise me when you see it?
Paul!
Zoey!
Oh, it's so good to see you.
How you doing?
I'm really good. I'm fine.
It's good to see you, Bubba.
It's good to see you, too.
Hey, you okay?
Me? Yeah, I'm absolutely fine. Actually, no, I'm hiding. I think I may have severely maimed a customer.
Oh, that was you. Funny, you don't look evil.
I'm not evil, I'm just a really bad waitress.
Well, I wouldn't worry. His last picture lost 20 million, and he's a lousy tipper. I'm Jed Stone.
Hi, Rachel.
Hi, Rachel. You know what every great waiter needs?
What?
A great teacher. Come on.
You've got a lot of teaching to do.
Yeah. Ah, splendid.
All right, fellas, listen, Bradley, I'm so glad that you could make it because you can meet the other three quarters of Guyz Incorporated, Zach, Jack and Brian. Bradley, fellas.
Hey, dear boys.
Mickey, Brian's breadsticks are longer than mine.
They are not.
Well, I don't have any. Give me that.
Hey, no way, get off!
You keep your
Mickey, he's doing breadsticks again.
Doing.
Would you guys please, we're here to talk business, all right? Now, The official launch of Guyz Incorporated is going to take place at the Battle of the Bands on Saturday.
What?
What's the matter? You got a problem with that?
Well, no, man, I haven't.
Good.